We don't like our behavior always. We don't respect bad behavior. But we never show contempt toward the spirit of a man, unless you want an enemy. But what I discovered is the crazy cycle. When a wife feels unloved, she tends to react in a way that feels disrespectful to her husband.
Wow. 5 years ago, something like that, the first time I read the book, and you have no idea how much you have helped so many couples in the company, people that we know, people at church. So can you remind us about the scripture that the book talks about, everybody has to know about that scripture?
Yes, well, most would say that a book in the Bible called Ephesians and the fifth chapter is considered the greatest treatise in the New Testament on marriage. And the summary, it'd be like, you know, if my father was on his deathbed, he said, "Emerson, come close, son, listen to me." You know, whatever the last words of someone dying, what they say is most important. It's almost like Abba Father is saying, "Come close, church, listen to me. These are my last words. And if you get this, you're going to be okay in your marriage. You really will be okay. You're going to have troubles at times, but you're going to be okay." And there we read that a husband must love his wife and a wife must respect her husband. Now, there's no controversy about the first part.
It's always about the second
part. But when we talk about that second part, women say, "Well, Dr. Emerson, respecting my husband, you don't want to be a hypocrite. I'm not going to do what I don't feel. He's not superior to me. I'm not inferior to him. He has to earn it. He hasn't deserved it. I'm not going to feed his ego. It's all about his narcissism. I'm certainly not going to give him license to do what he wants to do. I'm not going to return to male patriarchy. I'm not going to subject myself to emotional abuse. I'm not going to do these things." But but other than those things, I'm really open to hearing what you have to say about this. And that's been the response. Women are not mean-spirited, but what you and I serve and die for honor. We are highly motivated by unconditional respect toward our spirit. We give unconditional positive regard toward our spirit. We don't like our behavior always. We don't respect bad behavior, but we never show contempt toward the spirit of a man, unless you want an enemy.
Right.
And so what I discovered is that a woman, by and large, needs love, though she needs respect, and a man needs to feel respected for who he is apart from his performance, and the Bible is revealing that. The question on the table is, what does that look like? And we can address that. But what I discovered is the crazy cycle. When a wife feels unloved, she tends to react in a way that feels disrespectful to her husband.
Wow.
That's what happens. It's within her nature to appear that way. That's not her intent. And when we feel dis, we tend to react in a way that feels unloving to her. And this creates the crazy cycle. Without love,
the crazy cycle,
she reacts without respect. Without respect, he reacts without love. Without love, she reacts without respect. Without respect, he reacts without love. Without love, and it starts spinning. In couples of goodwill, there isn't evil will. We didn't marry Hitler's distant cousin, did we? And we start spinning. Does this make sense? And it's based on Ephesians 5:33 that you referenced.